What's going on, y'all? Nick, oh, coming to you with another video. So you guys, hot off the press, we see a video that Pastor Dowell has made. It's called Inheritance Rights in Captivity. Where is it? It's a very short video, but I'm gonna let it play and then I'm gonna attempt to answer Pastor Dowell, because Pastor Dowell seems very sincere in this video. He seems like he actually wants help in regards to finding the answer to this. So let's see if we can help him out here. All right. All right. So check this out.
You know, I'm going to go ahead and hit this with a question, because there's a lot of people out there that believes in fancy themselves to know, or at least they think they know, the scriptures and the word of God. So I'm going to pose this question like this. Okay. When in captivity, you know, as Israel, when we're in captivity, where are the inheritance rights for being in captivity? Where are the instructions that tells us what to do when we are in captivity? I'll be waiting, because there's a lot of people out there talking about inheritance rights, and they have no clue. All they're doing is repeating what somebody else said. So now I'm asking a question. And I'm waiting for all of y'all self-perceived scholars out there to give an answer. We'll all be waiting. Love to hear it.
All right. So I know he's throwing terms like self-perceived of scholars and, you know, self-proclaimed scholars, whatever the case may be. He's throwing these terms out there. But I think he's actually sincere. I actually do think he's sincere in this question of his. So let's actually attempt to answer this question. And the way I wish to go about answering the question is to simply use his own words, right? Because I think in times past, Pastor Dowell has adequately answered what we should do during captivity. So maybe he's forgotten. So I'm going to just use his own words and help him figure it out. All right. So let's go to this last great day Sabbath service. All right. And let's check out what he had to say back then.
Said what happened when you do this. Hold that for a second. Go to Mark chapter 10 and read verse 28, 29, and 30. Y'all all right, Pastor? Y'all good? What we in? What are we in? We're in the Word.
All right, y'all. So you heard that? We in the Word. All right, so let's go to the Word, according to Pastor Dowell. Let's hear this.
What? Is the Word offending you? Huh? We go to the Word, and the Word was made flesh. The Word that was made flesh.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what this Word that was made flesh had to say. Read.
Then Peter began to say unto him,
what did he say?
Oh, we have left all and have followed you.
Whoa. What have you left? I know what they did. Because he said, we left all to follow you. What have you left? Answer.
Now, you know, that's a very good statement, you know, because this is what you need to understand. The context within Straitway, for those who actually reach that far, you see, I'm not concerned about the people who have never lived communally or lived on community, and then they have, you know, things to say about me or have a testimony of me leaving, such as Horace. I have no issue with those people. They're the least of my concerns. But for the people that actually have lived communally, you need to understand that essentially, because of the way Pastor reads and interprets Acts 2, verse 44, on down, right? You need to understand that we have all been indoctrinated through Dowellism to sell everything you have. So as far as I'm concerned, all those who actually have lived on community, whether it be in a homestead or whether it be on actual boots on the ground, you know, on purchased land, these are all individuals to some extent that have given all, right? Just like the apostles have done. So we all should be expecting this, all right? You need to understand this, y'all. So let's see what Pastor Dowell has to say.
Ain't no time to be silent now. We in the Word, right? Then Peter said, Lord, we have left all to follow you. Come on.
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus answered and said,
oh, here we go. And the Word answered and said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Now the Word is getting ready to talk. The Word is getting ready to talk. You know the Word. The Word.
And shout out to Brother Marcus, by the way. Shout out to Brother Marcus, who took Tammy, his wife. Let's go.
There's supposed to be greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. The Word. The same Word. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. The same Word that says, I am Yahweh your Elohim, and I change not. Therefore, you sons of Jacob, not consumed. That Word. See, the devil flees when the Word is being preached. The devil flees when the Word is said. When the Word. See, we're making sure in this eighth day before you go up to this dead season, that we get a lot of these spirits up off you. By giving you something to go on. The Word. The Word of Yahweh Elohim.
Verily I say unto you, there is no man that has left house.
Uh-oh.
Or brethren.
Uh-huh.
Or sisters.
Is this the Word? Yeah. Come on.
Or father.
Or father.
Or mother.
Or mother.
Or wife.
Or wife. Come on.
Or children.
Or children.
Or lands.
Or lands.
For my sake and the good news.
Turn me up a little bit. For my sake and the message. For my sake and the gospel, right? For my sake and the gospel. Come on.
But he shall receive 100-fold now.
Whoa. He's going to receive 100-fold in the kingdom.
Now.
He's going to receive 100-fold in the next 50 years.
Now.
All right, so you guys, you see that? So Pastor Dowell's own words, as he's preaching on this last great day, he states that for people who have given all, right, brother, sister, father, mother, wives, lands, they shall receive 100-fold now. So this is what I'm not understanding. Okay, so for him to say that there is no inheritance now, you know, where's the instruction for inheritance while we in captivity? I mean, so why is Straitway doing anything that it's doing? Why are they going about building houses? What are they doing it for? Why did they do all this sacrifice for if they're not going to receive anything in return? I mean, let's actually look into this, y'all. I'm in the Blue Letter Bible, and I believe he said it was Mark chapter 10. Let's check this out. So I'm going to scroll down to verse 30, and let's see what it has to say, right? It says, but he shall receive 100-fold now, in this time, houses and brethren and sisters and mothers and children and lands with persecution, and in the world to come, eternal life. So right now, not in the kingdom, right now, we need to be receiving houses, brethren, sisters, and mothers, and children, and lands, and persecution. Let's check this out. Let's go deeper. Let's look at this word, receive. If we look behind that word, let me see. He shall receive. All right. That's come from the Greek number 2983. We look up behind that word, and look at what it says. To take with the hand, lay hold of any person or thing in order to use it. All right. Let's look at another one, right? If you look at number 3, it said to take what is one's own. Doesn't that sound like possession, that you have possession over this stuff, right? To take to oneself, to make one's own, to claim, procure for oneself. Procure. Let's actually look up that word, procure, y'all. Procure definition. Definition. Let's check up with the word. Obtain something, especially with care or effort. All right? To obtain something. but we don't have an inheritance. There's no inheritance rights. Right? There's no inheritance rights. I mean, last time I checked, according to his doctrine, we are in captivity right now to the European nations. So if we are in captivity right now, right now, we need to be receiving. Let's go back. Let's go back to what it says, right? We need to be receiving, y'all. Check this out. A hundredfold now in this time while we in captivity. Houses and brethren and sisters and mothers and children and lands. What's wrong with that? I mean, he preaches the doctrine. That's why he does it. That's why he's building all these houses, y'all. Because he's trying to receive it now. So what's this rhetoric? But let's keep going, because I actually do think he's sincere. Let's actually go back to another thing that he said, right?
Of the land unto your children evermore. Jeremiah chapter 29.
All right, so now he's going to go into Jeremiah 29, and this is the hallmark chapter that this man uses when you are in captivity. Let's go.
Let's read 4 through 6. The word. The word. To the law and to the testimony. If they speak not according to this word, that's because there's no light in them at all.
Yeah, I agree.
The word,
I agree.
You better don't harden your heart. You better let this word quicken you. You better let it touch you.
I agree. For those of you guys who, because I already proved that they're vow breakers. I already know that they've been listening to my videos already. I already know, all right? So, but for those who have already broken these vows, don't let your heart be hardened when you listen to the word. Don't let it be hardened. Let it be soft, malleable. Be able to receive the word of Yeshua, Jesus the Christ, yeah? I mean, the word... You see this man constantly saying, hey, the word was made flesh. Jesus is literally speaking to you this day. Listen to it. Because Jesus clearly said you need to be receiving a hundredfold now if you've done all these sacrifices. Again, I'm not concerned for the people who never lived on community. I'm not concerned about, you know, I'm not concerned about you guys. Because y'all could have talk all day, but y'all don't even know the sacrifice of selling everything. So my concern is not for you. But even at that, don't let your hearts be hardened, because you can receive the word just the same. Hopefully you might be able to listen to what's being said in this video, and then you can avoid the mistake that many saints have done by giving all through this heretical doctrine. But let's keep going. Okay, so unto all that is carried away captive. So just understand that as we proceed, this is the instruction given to you when you are in captivity. Let's see if they are asking us to have an inheritance. Let's read it.
Whom I have called to be carried away from Jerusalem unto Babylon.
Hey, ain't we in Babylon?
Yeah.
Ain't we being carried away
captive? You see, so I'm not making it up. He said, aren't we in Babylon? Aren't we being carried away, captive? This is this man's own words, y'all. Let's go.
Ain't we the descendants of the people being carried away? We ain't in Jerusalem. Hallelujah. Unto all. This ain't yesterday, today, and forever. What I say to one, I say to all. Come on. Historical. Here we go.
Build your houses.
No. No, you can't.
So the first thing they tell you is to build these houses. So let me guess. So these people were in captivity. And while they're in captivity, they're trying to build houses so that what? So that they won't inherit it? Oh, let's just build houses just for fun then. Let's just build houses just for fun. I mean, we don't got nothing better to do. Right? Ain't nothing better to do.
Let's just slave away in this hot sun. You know, after all, our inheritance is in the kingdom.
Our inheritance is in the kingdom. So let's just build houses for fun.
We'll be doing that. But that's the word. What do you think we're going to be doing in the kingdom? What do you think I'll be doing? Why do you think that I always keep my foot up in your ass? Plowing in this word. You're going to be building houses now, and you're going to be building them in the kingdom too. So you better get used to building. That's the word. Read.
And dwell in them.
And when you build them, you dwell in them. Come on.
You dwell in them. So when you build a house, you dwell in them. I guess that applies until, you know, the leader of said community gets butthurt and he kicks you out. You build a house and you dwell in it, your inheritance, but that inheritance ceases the moment the leader of the community gets butthurt and he kicks you off.
And plant gardens.
Plant gardens.
And eat the fruit of them.
And you eat the fruit of it. What do you think we're going to be doing in the kingdom? Read.
Take you wives.
Take you wives. Take you what?
Wives.
Well, now or in the kingdom? Now or in the kingdom?
Now. He's saying it. Now or in the kingdom? Now. Now in the kingdom. Now. You see all the... All the blind witnesses in that congregation, they all say it now. Because you got to understand, they just finished reading the Mark chapter 10. So you need to understand, they are expecting to receive these things now. But I guess there's no inheritance. A house, the house that you're living in is not for inheritance.
There's a translation out there says that they're neither married or given in marriage. If that's the case, then how the children get to the kingdom? That's true. I'm telling y'all, man, y'all better be careful of these European translations, man. Y'all better stop. Look.
Now, you need to be careful of Dowell's interpretation of the scriptures. That's what you need to be careful for. I mean, I just don't understand, right? What the Bible literally commended the Bereans and said they were more noble than those who were in Thessalonica. Why? Because they looked, they searched to see if whether or not the things that Paul was saying was so. But now we in the daytime and hour where Pastor Al can literally just open his mouth and say any damn thing and nobody's going to check behind it. Nobody's going to check behind it. Nobody has the unction to be like, ah, maybe we need to look behind what this man is saying. And mind you, Pastor Dowell is not even an apostle. I proved that a long time ago with his false predictions by toilet paper. Do you guys know? Do you know this man had the nerve to create another video after we've done proved that the toilet papers are made in America? This man had the nerve to actually say, oh, I told you to buy a toilet paper because I was hoping that deep down inside you guys would buy canned goods.
You know, I made a video and I showed you where I went out and bought a whole bunch of extra toilet paper. Now, the reason why I highlighted toilet paper, because I figured that if you people would get toilet paper, if I highlighted toilet paper, that you would probably go buy canned goods because you know that none of you are gardening.
Why did you have to go beat around the bush? Why did you have to be so, you know, indirect and tell people to buy toilet paper in hopes for them to buy canned goods? Just say buy canned goods. Isn't that simple? Isn't that much easier? Hey, you guys, go buy canned goods.
No. He was caught in a lie, and now he has to save face rather than just repent. Let's repent, bro. I was telling people to buy toilet paper because I was hoping that they're going to buy canned goods. Woo! But now, let's get back on track. Let's get back on track, y'all. Let's
get back. Behind the word is there not going to be children in the kingdom? Do you think they're just going to be spiritually birthed? My Easter's, y'all come up here. Y'all still love the word? Yes. We're going to find out. Can't some of y'all feel your deliverance?
Can they feel deliverance? Nah, I think these people feel that oppressive, that oppression, depression. they feel stressed out, vexed. This word was so, this, I don't know, this sermon was so damning to the souls. But let's keep going, y'all.
Y'all come on anytime for the month of October. Read that part again.
Take you wives.
Take you what?
Wives.
All right, now go back to the build you what?
Build you houses.
Build you houses.
Dwell in them.
And dwell in them.
Plant gardens.
And do what? And plant gardens. And plant gardens. Now, let me ask you a question. Would you be blessed if you did all this?
Yes.
Or would you be cursed? Huh?
All right, remember that. Remember that. Would you be blessed or would you be cursed? Let's actually look into that, y'all. Let's look at that, because I was reading Jeremiah 28, you know, we all know Jeremiah 28, where they talk about the blessings and the curses. Yeah, you know, you guys know about that one, right? And, you know, if anybody doesn't know that, pretty much from Deuteronomy 28, verse 1 to 14, it talks about all the blessings. And then from 15 on down is going to be all the curses. Let's actually read this out, right? But it shall come to pass if thou will not hearken unto the voice of Yahweh that Elohim, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake you. You know what's one of the curses? You know what's one of the curses? Right? Let's go to verse 30. It says, thou shalt betroth a wife, and another man shall lie with her. Doesn't that sound familiar? Didn't we just hear about a brother who betrothed the wife, but another man, you know, married her? Okay. I guess that's part of the curses from breaking the law. That's very commonplace in Straitway, by the way. Thou shalt build a house, and thou shalt not dwell therein. Interesting. Do you know how many brothers labored in Straitway? You know, you have Victor, you have Ray, you have Brother Richard. They all labored. They were helping out building these things, right? And now, the moment the leader gets butthurt, get off the land, get off. It's crazy, y'all. Oh, but that's why. Okay, let's keep going. It says, thou shalt plant a vineyard and thou shalt not gather the grapes thereof. You know who was laboring in that vineyard? Brother Rich. Oh, yeah, man. This brother was just plowing away, laboring. And again, Pastor Dowell gets butthurt, kick him off the land. So now it starts making sense to me. Ah, I see. Not, that's the reason why Pastor says, okay, where is their inheritance rights, you know, when you're in captivity? It makes sense now because they're living under the curses. How did I not? You know what? I understand. My apologies. I repent, y'all. I repent. I don't know what I was thinking. You know, I was thinking that, you know, we're keeping the commandments, so we're blessed. But, you know, I didn't know that all this time we've been cursed. I didn't know. My fault, y'all. I don't know why I even made this video. This was such a waste of time. I should have known. Why did you guys make me go this long? Why did you guys make me go this long? I should have known that we are cursed because we're not keeping the commandments. And that's the reason why we could build a house and other people would dwell in it. I didn't know that before. My fault, y'all. Do you guys see what's going on here? Do you see what's going on here? Clearly, I'm being facetious, right? Clearly, I'm being facetious. So let's keep going. Let's see what this man has to say.
I mean, because I read that the blessing of Yahweh is rich and have no sorrow. That's what I'm saying. If you want to be blessed coming in and blessed going out, I mean, would you not be blessed if you did all this? If you don't do all this, would you not be cursed?
And guess what, y'all? I agree with him. I agree with him. I mean, if you do all these things that is prescribed to you in Jeremiah 29, when you're in captivity, wouldn't you be blessed? Wouldn't you build a house and be able to dwell in it? You're not going to build a house for another person to dwell in it, right? Right? You're not going to betroth a wife so another man can marry your wife, right? I mean, you guys got to think, y'all. I mean, even a child that gets produced from the union of a man and woman coming together, don't they produce an heir? An heir? Which comes from the word inheritance, heritage, right? That's your inheritance, y'all. That's your inheritance, y'all. When you do these things, that's your inheritance. Even while you're in captivity, the vineyards, the houses, the wives, the children, that's all your inheritance, y'all.
You may be seated. And then what else he say?
I need to prune to them. Take you wives.
Am I taking wives? Am I taking wives? Is that your...
Now, and you got to understand the mindset of some of these individuals, right? The seals clapping, you got to understand what's taking place. Because when they clapping for this, you need to understand that psychologically, he notice what he said. He said, aren't I blessed? Yeah, he's blessed because he has multiple wives, right? And now you have some of these betas, right? These beta males within the congregation, they clapping because deep down inside, they're not communicating it to y'all. But this is their mindset. They're hoping that if they just brown nose long enough, you know, my mom would call it Hershey's Kisses. Hershey Kisses. You get the lips become brown. You guys get it. You know, if they become Hershey Kisses, if they brown nose long enough, you know, they got to stick that nose deep inside. Oh, mercy. I don't mean to create so much imagery, y'all. But I mean that's what's taking place. They shove their nose so deep. They brown nose so much, and they're hoping that one day they too could be on top, that they could have the multiple wives, so that they could boss men around, that they could lord over people's lives. You gotta understand this, y'all. I'm just the only person bold enough to actually, you know, just reveal it to y'all, but that is the mindset of some of these people. And what they don't understand is that, look, some of these men, they will never, leadership is never going to even entertain the fact of them having multiple wives. You know, let me touch on this while I'm at it, because I forgot to mention it in the other video. You remember that brother Horace, the brother that flip-flopped? One minute he sees what's taking place with the pen, the next minute he doesn't see it no more. Right? Do you know this brother? This is what I mean by I don't care about the opinions of people who have not sacrificed and made it as far as to even live communal like I did. Because this is the same brother who literally told me that, mind you, he's not on community, y'all. And I asked him, do you desire to be on community? He said, unless a leader of that community can help me accomplish my goals, I don't want to be a part of community. And I said, what's your goals? And you know what this brother Horace said to me? He said that my goals is to have 8 wives and 20 children. 8 wives and 20 children. Now, guess what? If I'm lying, Brother Horace, I want you to make that video and say that I'm lying. I want you, Horace, to come out in public and say that I'm lying. And guess what? I'm so confident in what I've heard that I know that if this man comes out and say I'm lying regarding this information, this man has literally damned his soul. He literally just damned himself. That's how confident I am, y'all. He said he wants 8 wives and 20 children. And unless a leader of a community can provide him the opportunity to accomplish those goals, he doesn't even want to be on community. But this is who Pastor will put up. He will put up people that don't even agree with the lifestyle that he's living, or what, to make his enemies look bad. So, hey, Pastor Dowell, how about you go provide Horace with land, inheritance, bring him on your community, and provide him with those 8 wives and 20 children. Provide him with that. Let's see how that works out. 8 wives and 20 children. Mercy.
The word. Is that the word? That's beautiful, too. All of this is beautiful. Look at these nice sons of Israel. The warriors. Huh? And I also got one in here. Am I blessed or am I cursed? Am I blessed or am I cursed?
You guys got to understand. He said, am I blessed? Am I blessed? Or am I cursed? He's not saying, are we? He's not saying that, y'all. He's saying, am I blessed? Because he understands deep down inside that he does have a house that belongs to him. He does have wives that belong to him. He does have vineyards that belong to him. But the saints, hey, if they catch a case of the ass, and that catching a case of the ass is determined by what's in his mind, what's in his opinion. You got to understand that, right? If you prove him wrong using scripture, he's going to get butt hurt and he's going to kick you off that land. And all that work that you spent for those years, is all for naught. Yeah, because it shows that you're cursed. He's blessed, but y'all cursed. Those of you in Straitway, y'all definitely cursed because y'all don't have an inheritance. That's not my words. That's his word. He said, where's the instruction? This is literally what he said in the beginning of this video. He said,
when in captivity, you know, as Israel, when we're in captivity, where are the inheritance rights for being in captivity? Where are the instructions?
Where is the instruction for inheritance while you're in captivity? Meanwhile, he's literally stating all his inheritance. He's literally saying how much he's blessed. But hey, you guys are cursed. Let's go. You see that? I'm just telling you, it's all in the speech. What's wrong with me performing the word? Mind you, he lives with a bunch of saints on that line. He's not saying what's wrong with us performing the word. What's wrong?
Bless y'all. Thank y'all very much.
All right. So let's actually really put the nail in the coffin, because again, I want to use his own words, but I want to touch on a passage of scripture that I ran into, you know. Let's actually go to Ezra chapter 9, and we're going to start reading from, I believe, it's verse, let's check this out here. Let's start from reading from verse 5, all right? This is Ezra. Now, understand the context of Ezra, right?
Let's actually go here. Let me show it to you guys. Google, what kingdom was ruling during the time of Ezra? All right. The Persian dynasty ruled the area during the time of Ezra. Do you guys see that? The Persian dynasty. All right. The biblical books of Ezra and Nehemiah describe Ezra as arriving in Jerusalem during the seventh year of King Artaxerxes. All right. So, you guys, this is clear. They are in captivity. Although they might be in Jerusalem, but they are in captivity. And the chapter that I'm about to read is going to explain it for you guys. But let's go. All right. So, verse 5, it says, "And at the evening sacrifice, I arose." This is Ezra. "I rose up from my heaviness, and having rent my garment and my mantle, I fell upon my knees and spread out my hands unto Yahweh my Elohim, and said, O my Yah, I am ashamed and blush to lift up my face to thee, my Yah, for our iniquities are increased over our head, and our trespasses grown up into the heavens, unto the heavens. Verse 7. Since the days of our fathers have we been in great trespass unto this day." You see, hence why they are in captivity. "And for our iniquities have we, our kings and our priests, been delivered into the hand of the kings of the lands, and to the sword, to captivity, and to a spoil, and to confusion of face, as it is this day. And now for a little space," this is verse 8, "and now for a little space, grace has been showed from the master, our Elohim, to leave us a remnant to escape and to give us a nail in his holy place." You see, so people might say, oh, you see, they escaped. No, let's keep reading. "That our Elohim may lighten our eyes and give us a little reviving in our bondage." So they still in bondage, y'all. They're in captivity. They are in bondage. Again, they were under the Persians at this time. Verse 9, "For we were bondmen, yet our Elohim have not forsaken us in our bondage, but have extended mercy unto us in the sight of the king of Persia." All right. "To give us a reviving, to set up the house of our Elohim, and to repair the desolations thereof, and to give us a wall in Judah and in Jerusalem. And now, O our Elohim, what shall we say after this? For we have forsaken thy commandments." Check this out, y'all. "Which thou hast commanded by the servants, the prophets, saying, The land unto which ye go to possess it," to possess it, to possess it, "is an unclean land, with the filthiness of the people of the lands, with their abominations, which have filled it from one end to another with their uncleanness." All right. Check this out. "Now, therefore, give not your daughters unto their sons." All right. "Neither take their daughters unto your sons, nor seek their peace or their wealth forever, that ye may be strong and eat the good of the land." Oh, okay. Eat the good of the land, like, you know, planting vineyards. Right. "And leave it for an inheritance." Oh, "to your children forever." Oh my gosh. So while they were in captivity, this is the instruction that they are given, right? "Don't give your daughters to them, and neither marry their daughters. And what? Don't seek their peace or their wealth," right? Eat the good of the land. This is lining up with Jeremiah. "And leave it for an inheritance." Leave it for an inheritance. All right? And let's check this out, right? We got to check this out. You see, this is Proverbs 13:22. And look at what it says. It says, "A good person leaves an inheritance for their children's children, but a sinner's wealth is stored up for the righteous." You see, this is what you guys got to understand, y'all. That scripture, mind you, he was saying the word, Jesus,
right, is not being followed in Straitway. Because apparently nobody could be good in Straitway. Nobody can. Everybody is just wicked. They just evil. I mean, this is not me saying this. This is according to their doctrine. Because if they were good, they would leave an inheritance for their children's children. But I guess they don't have no inheritance in this day, time, and hour, right? Even though they just read Mark, I believe, 10, right? Where it said that you're going to have it now. What now? The houses, right? The wives? You're going to have 100-fold now. But now it don't exist for not for Straitway. Or rather, let me be more concrete. It the now exists for Pastor Dowell. The 100-fold that they're going to receive now, that's for Pastor Dowell. He's the one that's blessed. Everybody else is cursed. They cursed. So this is the reason why you can't be a good person. You can't leave an inheritance for your children's children, because he's going to now manipulate you and say, oh, you know, your inheritance is in the kingdom. So what happened to the now? What happened to the now? Again, you guys are missing it. It's for Pastor Dowell. The now is for Pastor Dowell, y'all. All right? The now is for Pastor Dowell. So don't keep asking me this. I already done explained to y'all. All right? It's us. We need to actually get to his level. We're the ones that's out of order. All right? Check this out. I want to show you something, right? 1 Timothy 5, verse 7 to 9. It says, and these things charge them that they may be blameless. If you want to be blameless, listen to this, y'all. But if any provide not for his own, especially for those of his own house, he have denied the faith and is worse than an infidel. All right, you guys, why am I ending off with this video? I'm going to land the plane by saying this. You know, there is a lot of men within that congregation. You guys are literal walking infidels. You guys have literally handed over your right as a patriarch of your home to these leaders, and they are the ones providing for your family. You're not doing that. And because you're not doing that, again, you're not blameless, and you are an infidel. It's actually quite sad, because now when you have someone like me who's talking about, the self-proclaimed scholar, you know, when I come out, the self-proclaimed scholar, you know, and I'm saying that, hey, Pastor Dowell, give these people their inheritance. Now, I'm wicked, because I want you guys to actually be blessed. I want you to be blessed. I want you to actually keep the commandments, but now I'm wicked. We self-proclaimed scholars. All right? You guys, listen up. How about you just question everything that this man has to say? Just question everything. It's your right to do so. The Bible says, trust no man. So just question everything that falls off his lip. You guys just blindly listen to what this man has to say. Do your due diligence. Practice self-autonomy. Stop trying to attack us, because we're telling you to follow the book. It is your right to leave an inheritance for your children's children. That's your right. If you wish to be a good person, a good man, that's what you ought to do. Not just give your money and thereby cursing yourself. How are we cursing ourselves? Again. If you build a house on a straightway and you can get kicked out and you lose all your inheritance, then you are cursed. That's just a fact. That's just a fact. Don't get mad at me. Get mad at the word. Get mad at the word. If you can build a house, if you could plant a vineyard, if you could get betrothed to a wife and all these things could be taken away from you just like this, bang, you are cursed. And I'm going to let you know right now, the infrastructure, the system whereby Straitway operates, it is a system designed to keep you cursed. This is why I say, Pastor Dowell, how about you just repent? That's all you really got to do. All you really need to do is just repent. There's still some hope. And I think that video, although he was throwing a little jazz, self-proclaimed scholar, no, you still have a chance to be saved. Now, just repent. Just repent. give people their inheritance. If people wish to leave, let them leave. I just found out today that a brother was kicked out of Clarksville. I thought I held the record of 48 hours. A brother, I got beat. A brother was kicked off the community over there in Clarksville in a day, 24 hours. He spent years giving them his money, blood, sweat, and tears. Kicked out, boom, just like that. Anyway, hey, you guys, I think Pastor Dowell was sincere. I think he actually genuinely wanted to know if there's inheritance or instructions for inheritance while you're in captivity. And I tried my best to help him out because I do believe he was coming from a sincere place. If I answered the question adequately, please put it in the comment section down below. If you don't agree, put it down below. I would love to learn. Hey, I'm not above correction. I'm not above correction, believe me. But if you guys did like the video, please like, subscribe, comment down below, do all that YouTube stuff. Share, more importantly, because that's what actually wake the people up, y'all. That's what wake the people up. Anyway, y'all, with that being said, Nick over and out. The message sent. Jesus is King, y'all.
I think it's sad how much hatred they are displaying, but so quickly. Like, they just left from the feast to be so disgruntled and showing such vindiction against us as a people, as if we've done such wrong things against them. And then they think that once the enemy takes the blinders off, they're going to come crawling back saying sorry, and we're going to open our doors and be all excited that they're back. But it's like, you did not wait a week, a month. You immediately went out there to speak such evil, wickedness things against the man of Yah and Yah's people. And you think that the Most High ain't watching you and seeing this and it's not going to judge you? You're receiving exactly what you need to receive.